So we left our house, which was good, but not as good as theirs. For them, they always a class ahead. So we actually took over their house in Kenya.
Yeah.
And stayed there. We not paid any penny. Then Rita said, when you come to Canada, you'll find us there. I said, I'll never come to Canada. Only 3 years later, we come to Canada, and it's the same Dirota and Angel that welcomed us. Gave us our first car that had their name on it differently.
Dirota.
I don't know if it was Dirota 1 or Dirota 2. So since that time, we've actually been with the Dirotas since Kenya time. You can imagine how far the girls come from.
Yeah.
Born in Uganda, immediately flown into Kenya, grew up in Kenya.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you remember your
Kenya.
First school. Mm-hmm. That's why I'm sure I still carry this. We lived about 6 years in Kenya.
Mm-hmm.
The first school was called Master.
Dentistry.
One of them could not pronounce S.
They
don't have S in their vocabulary. So she would just say Dana Cool. Instead of Dennis Prince School, you just said Dana Cool. When they left and came to Canada, they went to Master School, they would call it Mata. They didn't have S. You know? So that's how far they come from Kenya. We were with the Dirotas. Then we come to Canada. We find Brother Rais. We would ask, where are Ugandans? That's the Rais at Makerere University. So I was told by Ugandans that Rais is around where you are, in Scarborough. We looked for Rais, we got him. We arrived at Salali's home. Salali is a good friend of Bashir. We lived with Salal for a month and a half. Salal left his bedroom with his wife. They lived in the living room, and for us, the four displaced them and took over the master bedroom for 1.5 months. So Salal was not able to be here, but he wished us so well. So we thanked him so much. So when we came to Canada, we thought it was greener pastures. We came as, you know, skilled.
Yeah.
We thought we'd be getting better jobs and so on.
Yeah.
But every time I went for any interview, they would say I'm overqualified with no Canadian experience. The only job I could do, I couldn't even be a tailor. And then I was a gentleman in the back home in a big bank. And so we decided that I study again in the Canadian style that they would recognize. So the family decided to go back to Kenya. Our businesses were still there. So meanwhile, I didn't know how to prepare or cook anything. We are the spoiled Africans.
Even to this day.
I couldn't even open a box or a can of beans. So at one time, I had to drive all the way from Mississauga to come and help me open and show me how to, you know, prepare a meal. But Rais and the wife, Sabah, were always there. They would come and prepare meals for me for a whole week, put them in the fridge, come the next weekend. So they really loved us so much. It's always important to recall a few of those extra mile offers, which makes the bond, the brotherhood bond. So Rais, I can never forget you. You made me happy. So there was a course I had to do for 6 months. But because I have support of everyone, I was living alone, I was studying night and day. I managed to crack it within a month and 2 weeks. And out of 210 people, it's 3 who passed, and I was one of them. The pass mark was 80%.
And you got 80.
I got 81. Yes. And there was a whole Indian whose name I can't remember. He actually paid it for me. Little did I know that once I get a job, he gets paid as a recruiter. My 3 months, and I still get paid. So that's Rais, and now my doc, all the way from Senior 1 to ASS.
No.
He has decided to grow younger.
He refuses to age.
Yeah, he grew old, but he's a full qualified medical doctor.
Right? And I know and I know how to cook. I mean,
YouTube.
No.
So right from senior one where I was a doc, Chibuli Secondary School, you don't know Chibuli Secondary School, it was a border. Our meal was always posho ugali, which is, what is posho?
Ugali.
Translate for trees.
It's like
mashed
potatoes. Cornmeal. Like mashed potatoes made of flour.
Yeah. Cornmeal, we have that in our
So when I arrived from senior one, Chibuli, and I always ate him in class. When it was always him, so we used to alternate. Yeah. He was good at sciences and mathematics. For me, I was good at arts.
Wait, what? Are you serious? Are you serious?